Jamie, I just want to tell you that you're the woman of my dreams. When I met you in Anchorage, I thought you were with somebody else, and I was pretty jealous. But whenever you started talking to me, that lit up my world, and I couldn't be a happier man. You made me very happy, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you, and have children with you, and go to church with you, and go to games with you, and just raise our babies and live our lives. I love you very much, and I look forward to seeing you today.
Wanted to tell you I love you, and I may have been upset some of the times when you don't help me pick out decisions, but that's only because I wanted you to remember this for the rest of your life, and I wanted you to be happy when you saw me. And now it doesn't matter to me, as long as it's you that I say I do to, and it's you by my side, and I'm so happy I found you. I'm blessed. And I hope I have many, many more years to be with you.
I want to sleep with you forever, and I want to die in your arms, in a cabin by a meadow where the wild bees swarm. I'm gonna love you like nobody loves you. And I'll learn your trust making memories of us. I wanna honor your mother, and I wanna learn from your power. I wanna steal your attention like a bad outlaw. And I wanna stand out in the crowd for you, a man among men. I wanna make your world better than it's ever been. And I'm gonna like nobody loves you, and I'll learn your trust making memories of us. We'll follow the rainbow wherever the four winds go. There'll be a new day. From now on, yes, you know somehow. You've been stretched to the limits, but it's all right now. And I'm gonna make you a promise, if there's life after this, I'm gonna be there to meet you with a warm. I'm gonna love you like nobody loves you, and I'll win your trust making memories of us.
It is a heartfelt desire of Ross Bonas and Jamie Garcia to to welcome you to share and to celebrate their covenant and commitment of love. Because Ross and Jamie have indicated their love for each other, they've decided to join their lives together as husband and wife. Each of you have been invited as witnesses to hear Ross and Jamie promise to face the future together, accepting whatever lies ahead. Nothing in this world happens by chance or luck. God is in total control of all that happens. He has brought these two together for this special time and special ceremony. With Ross marrying today, it's not one family losing a son or a daughter. It's two families gaining a son or daughter. Would y'all bow and pray with me now, please? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blessings of life. We thank you for your presence at this special celebration. We thank you for the love that has drawn these two families together. We ask a special blessing today for Ross, Jamie, Desiree, and Dorian as they start a new life together. Draw them closer together and closer to you. In Jesus' holy name, amen. Y'all can be seated. Don't forget. I'll tell you. Ross, Jamie, in a few minutes, it'll be easy to say, I do. But living these words will not always be easy. There's nothing magical about this ceremony. Nothing that happens today will guarantee you a happy marriage. Marriage is a lifetime commitment that requires hard work and effort. For you to have a successful marriage requires many things. I'd like to share three things that I think is important keys to a happy marriage. The first thing to having a successful marriage is to have God at the center of your relationship. You need a vibrant personal relationship with Jesus Christ. It is God who created the institution of marriage. He is the author of love. Jamie, you are God's gift to Ross. Ross, you are God's gift to Jamie. Recognize that all of life's blessings come from God. Continually give him thanks and honor and respect this special gift that God has given you today. The second key to a happy marriage is to base the decisions you make in your life on the Word of God. The Bible is God's textbook for life and for a happy marriage. If you seek God's counsel through the Bible and through prayer, he will honor and bless your family and your marriage. The third key is a strong commitment to each other. Spend time together. Jesus' first miracle was at our wedding feast. Jesus' mother came to him and said, "We're running out of wine." Jesus' reply was, "Why are you telling me? My time has not come yet." Jesus' mother directed the servants, "Do as he asked you to do." He commanded the servants to go fill six pitchers with water. He didn't tell them to go gather grapes or ingredients to make wine. He said, gather six pitchers of water and take them to the master of the feast. And they did. The pitcher contained plain water until it was poured out into the master of the feast cup. When it was poured out, it became fine wine. Your love for each other is plain water until you pour it out. When you pour your love out by spending time together, respecting, honoring each other, doing the things that make each other happy, God will bless it and it will become the fine wine of your marriage. Remember, keep God as the center of your lives. Base your decisions on his word. Stay committed to each other, and God will bless your marriage and your family. Do these things, and one day, years from now, long after we're gone, a lot of us anyway, You'll be sitting around with your kids and your grandkids, and you'll say to them, like my dad said to me, you know, God has really blessed our family, and your mom was truly God's best gift he could have gave you. Ross, Jamie, with what I've said to you, is it still your desire to join yourself together and be married? Ross, take Jamie's hand in your right hand. Ross, do you in the presence of God and these witnesses promise to love and to cherish in sickness and in health, in prosperity and adversity, this gift from God, the woman whose hand you now hold? Do you promise to be a true and faithful husband to her in all things and to her only? Do you take her to be your lawful wedded wife as long as you both shall live? Do you, Jamie, in the presence of God and these witnesses, promise to love and to cherish in sickness and in health, in prosperity and in adversity, this gift from God, the man whose hand you now hold? Do you promise to be a true and faithful wife to him in all things, to cleave to him only? Do you take him to be your lawful wedded husband as long as you both shall live? Ross, Jamie, do you have a token of affection to show your love for each other? What is that token? The wedding ring symbolizes your love for each other. The ring is an unending circle which symbolizes the love between you that will never cease. The ring's untarnished gold represents the lasting quality of your love, a love that shall never grow old. Ross, take your ring for Jamie, place it on her on the finger of her left hand, and repeat after me. I, Ross Bonus, take you, Jamie Garcia, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Jamie, take your ring, place it on the finger of Ross's left hand. I, and repeat after me. I, Jamie Garcia, take you, Ross Bonus, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Okay, we will now celebrate Ross and Jamie's union with a symbolic sand ceremony. If we will move over and move on. First, Ross and Jamie will pour simply a layer of sand that represents who they are as individuals. The strong foundation of your relationship. This foundation includes their family, their upbringing, and all the important steps on their journey that led them to be here today. The foundation will support them in their love as they grow together. Next, Ross and Jamie will pour simultaneously. This represents the blending of their lives together in marriage. The sand may shift and blend in new ways, but they cannot be separated. They will remain joined forever. You also making a bond with your children, Dorian and Desiree, as they contribute their unique personalities and strength to this family. They will add a letter of sand, a layer of sand to this thing. Now, everyone, Ross, Jamie, Doran, Desiree, will pour together their own sand representing their commitment together. As the individual grains of sand no longer can be separated, they may be bonded. As the individual grains of sand can no longer be separated, may your bond be inseparable. Ross and Jamie, on the basis of your covenant of love, I pronounce you husband and wife. Greg, move back so that they can take a... Oh, that's Dennis. No, never mind. Let me step back. Ross, you can kiss the bride. Okay, I think they wanted everybody to kind of hang around and take pictures.
My feet and take me out to sea. Things are gonna be alright this time. If you got a reason, let it shine. Time to be on the sunny side of life. Not a single cloud up in the sky. Looking at the people passing by. Not a single reason to ever bat bye. Things are looking up now. Things are looking up now, wouldn't you say? Things are looking up now. One speed bump there to slow me down. I'm underneath the shade tree, thinking about what made me smile as bright as this new day. What do you say? Things are looking up now. Things are looking up now. What do you say? Things are looking up now. It's a big, bright, sunny day. Things are looking up now. Things are looking up now. What do you say? I've been feeling alive, not a cloud in the sky. I'll be keeping up my stride. Watching people passing by, no one looking for bad vibes. Walking on the sunny side of life. Things are looking up now. Things are looking up now, wouldn't you say? Things are looking up now. It's a big, bright, sunny day. Things are looking up now. Things are looking up now, wouldn't you say? Things are looking up now. It's a big, bright sun.